When a doctor could say three lives versus five lives, you know, nobody has a, you can't arrange to know how, could they really say five lives and they only say three? Or when a lawyer decides to mitigate, or, you know, whether they go to court, you never really knew because you can't, because you need to mitigate. And an accountant, you know, one accountant could have gotten $100 from your tax return, and another one could have gotten, a different one could have gotten $1,000 from your tax return. There's no way to really know who could have done something. But when you're talking about the built environment, you can get the project complete, and that building is there for 50 to 100 years. It doesn't matter who did something right or who did something wrong, you are stuck with what is on the environment. It's not like the problem goes away. It's there every day for somebody to see. So, and then with the second one coming into place, if the first one goes into place, then the second one can come into place, and then we're just opening the door for it happening everywhere. So that's what I'm really appealing to you again, because to adopt this emergency ordinance that would limit buildings in rural residential areas to 10,000 square feet just for 2 months to give us time to study all the issues. I mean, there are all kinds of issues that keep coming up and coming up and coming up, and we're just like, we're just chasing, you know, our tails trying to keep up with everything that comes in every day. So if we have this ordinance, we can do it right instead of, you know, scrambling to try to figure out what the next step is. So, that's what I have to say.
Are you committing to the board to pass the emergency ordinance?
Yes, I am. Because, you know, maybe for the county to change or move forward, maybe we just have to go up a couple of lawsuits to change the direction that the county is going. And I don't advocate for lawsuits because I think you should be able to work with people and work things out. But you know, that's what we're stuck with, is being told that we're going to be sued. I'd rather be sued for the right reasons than, you know, trying to do the right thing. So I do recommend that you do consider voting for the emergency ordinance.
Any comments from the board or questions?
I would love to find a way to vote for this if it's even moderately legally defensible. I'm wondering if you could tell us a little bit more specifically what the 60 days would, what would you be looking into, or what would you be, how would you use the 60 days? And then also, I'll just sort of lay out several questions here and answer them, however. When we look at things like the septic plan, and if you could help all of us, audience included, understand if this moratorium were or were not to be enacted, sort of what does the process look like? How does the septic plan get approved? What hoops would need to be jumped through in order, just under our normal existing code, for a project like this to meet approval in that location? What other things would our code require as it exists now? For example, would it have to be designed with fire suppression? And if so, who determines how much water needs to be stored on site? I've heard 10,000 gallons, I've heard 100,000 gallons. So if you could help us understand a little bit better, I guess another way to put it would be, if we don't pass the moratorium, how would you see this process moving forward compared to if we were to pass the moratorium, how you would see the process moving forward? I know that's a lot.
Yeah, so, what Andy said,
I don't know a lot about it. I'd say that if a moratorium is in place, we would be asking the prosecutor to talk what we, should we stop you do or continue? Because the moratorium is in place, so we don't, we have to be looking at the farm. What does that do for our heart? That's one thing. The other thing is, I think as far as talking is that part of an issue for us has been, what exactly is the use of this proposal as far as, is it residential, is it commercial? How, what's the water use? Because basically the septic system size and design is based on the soil and the water use. And I'm not sure, I don't know all the details.
No.
But some of those are the, I think, the issues I heard from staff. We don't know exactly what this is. So maybe you should maybe know more about that, but those are some of the things that we can do.
Right, so we don't really either. I mean, the report that we got yesterday, he says that the property can only handle
Remind me who the report is
from. Oh, from NTI. They're the ones that did the erosion, sediment, and drainage plan.
Okay.
So they're doing the septic design as well. And they said that they can only, the two properties can only have 8 bedrooms. Now, if you build one structure on one piece, because that's how they're having to put their drainage on the other piece of property that they own, and they're going to have to put, you know, then the next one next to it, and then the reserve area, then another one next to that. So they're using both properties for their septic design. But so if you build a second building on the second property, there's not enough land to, you know, deal with all the ramifications of both of these buildings. That doesn't appear to me. And they don't have a real accurate plot plan, so you can't really determine how far is it from the ordinary high water. We just don't have all the information. So it would go through, the building official has said that it's a hotel, but they're disputing that, and so we'd have to go to the county board of appeals to appeal it, or maybe we could send it to the International Code Council to get another objective opinion on it. So we really just, we're scrambling and trying to figure out what to do, and we just don't have the time to do it. Then if they see it as a hotel, then, you know, our planning codes would say, you know, hotels are prohibited to it. So hopefully then it would be a guilty hearing examiner, and maybe go to the Supreme Court. The attorney should say that on the case, just to the court by the way. We've been doing a lot of analysis of all the different buildings in the area to determine, well, how out of scale is it? So we'd like to do more.